to do it. Throughout the 2010s and into the first years of the 2020s, March usually meant postseason basketball for the Michigan Wolverines. After two straight tournament appearances in the beginning of head coach Juwan Howard's career at Michigan in 2021 and 2022, Michigan missed out on the dance last year and, barring winning the Big Ten tournament this season, will miss out on the tournament again. The past two seasons, especially this current one, have generated conversations surrounding what the future of the program will look like. Regardless of what's to come this offseason, there will surely be changes made internally. What specifically those changes will be, we're not yet sure, but Michigan basketball is due to make some headway this offseason. In the meantime, we welcome you into Crisler Center as Michigan closes out their regular season by welcoming in the Nebraska Cornhuskers. I'm joined on my left by color commentator Shai Dweck. Shai, how does Michigan approach this game? Do they prioritize ending the regular season with a win here on senior night, or do they experiment a bit with their rotations and their play style?
I think this is about winning, and I'll tell you why, Owen. This team has a culture fracture right now in the locker room. It lacks an identity, and you're right, there will be changes made, whether that's on the coaching staff or personnel. You could have many players who are now grad students, seniors, leaving. Maybe perhaps your best player in Doug McDaniel. Who knows what his future might be, potentially entering the transfer portal. We don't know, but to encourage not only those players to stay and to buy into this culture, you try to get a win here. You try to close your season out on a positive note for this, for these players, for this coaching staff on senior day as you move into next season. Because the reality is we don't know if these players, this personnel, will even be here next season to experiment with those lineups, Owen.
Michigan will have their hands full this afternoon with a Nebraska team that sits at 21-9 overall, 11-8 within the Big Ten. It's been a difficult conference this season. The Cornhuskers are looking to make the NCAA tournament, and this game could get them a double bye in the Big Ten tournament. Shai, this is Nebraska's first winning season since the 18-19 season. They're under fifth-year head coach Fred Hoiberg. They've got a balance. They've got a good team. They run eight deep. How will this Cornhuskers team challenge a Michigan team that struggled all season?
Well, the things that they do well is they are the top three-point shooting team in the Big Ten, averaging 9.4 three-pointers made per game. And then you combo that with size. They recently inserted Bryce Williams, 6'7 guard, into the starting lineup, mixing in with forward Juwan Gary, Josiah Alec in the big rank mass from the Netherlands. They have a lineup that has size and spacing. You have three guards coming off the bench that can all shoot the ball well from the perimeter. And Michigan has not done a good job of not only defending three-point shooting teams, defending teams with depth. The Michigan Wolverines are, let's just put it plainly, not good in the second half. That is where they struggle the most, so they will have to try to match this Wolverine depth. Let's see if some of those seniors who maybe play less, like Jalen Llewellyn, are able to come in and provide that depth and kind of match up with those perimeter guards that Nebraska will insert later in this game.
Starting lineup for the Cornhuskers. You mentioned not having really a true point guard in that starting lineup. It's Bryce Williams, the 6'7 guard, the senior guard, and Keisei Tominaga, who's been a familiar face for Michigan fans. They switch off handling the ball with that starting lineup. You mentioned three guards off the bench. So a lot of ball handling throughout the lineup, but for the starters in particular, it's Williams and Tominaga. You got Juwan Gary, Rainick Max, and Jolaya Alec to round out the front court for Nebraska. We are nearing tip here for Michigan. It's Doug McDaniel, Namari Burnett, Terrence Williams II, Terrace Reed Jr., and Will Cheddar as the starters. There was a little pregame ceremony that the program held for their departing seniors. Burnett and Williams were included in that. Both will start here this afternoon. Nebraska has taken the floor, and Michigan will do so here shortly.
Yeah, and I think it's just kind of a big, I think, potentially send-off for those two in Burnett and Terrence Williams II, who Terrence Williams II that has had a really nice year, averaging 12 points per game, shooting over 40%, I believe, from the three-point line. Been efficient for this Wolverines team. Burnett transferring over from Alabama in the transfer portal last offseason, was really asked to take a big jump here to be a starter, and has really excelled at times. You remember that big St. John's game he had early in the season, but ultimately maybe not able to provide as much of a scoring boost to that two-guard position that Michigan is accustomed to having in previous seasons with potentially guys like Kobe Bufkin and Jet Howard, who left for the NBA draft last year.
The last game in Crisler is underway for this season. Terrace Reed wins the tip. Ball goes to Doug McDaniel. Guarded closely there by Bryce Williams. Big size differential there. Burnett now comes. Top of the key. Guarded by Gary. Looking to move that offense off ball. Williams gets it left wing. Looking Reed in the inside. Here comes the double from Nebraska. Reed swings it back outside Williams. We've got 10 on the shot clock. Now Burnett, top of the key. High screen from Cheddar. Inside Terrace. Reed goes up and finishes. So Michigan starts up with a bucket. It's 2-0.
Really nice feed in there. Terrace Reed Jr. He just able to finish.
Williams now gets it to Mast, who hands back to Williams. Back up top, Mast. Couple big dribbles there, and Burnett goes up with the left and finishes. So Nebraska responds with the layup. It's 2-2.
Both teams working it into their bigs early, exploiting those mismatches and just getting easy layups. It's what Nebraska wants to do. Let's see if Michigan can maintain that physicality on the inside throughout the rest of this game.
Michigan back on offense. McDaniel up top. We've got 10 on the shot clock. Williams fires a three. That one goes for Terrence Williams the second. The senior, it's his first shot of the afternoon. It's 5-2 Michigan.
Really nice off-ball play design. Terrence Williams coming off the screen and banging home the trifecta.
Gary hands, Tominaga left wing, hounded by McDaniel. Back up top, it's Mast. Puts it on the ground, lefty layup is no good. Left it long, rebound Cheddar. Here comes Michigan in transition. McDaniel left wing, quick dribble. Step back three is up and good for Doug McDaniel. As Michigan's lead extends to six, it's 8-2 Wolverines. Williams drives down the lane and finishes. Got right past Namuri Burnett there. A little miscommunication there from Michigan defensively. Lead is cut to four. It's 8-4. We're approaching 18 to go in the first half. Williams puts it on the ground. Rises, no good. Wanted a foul there. Won't get it. Here comes Gary the other way for the Cornhuskers. Gary swings it outside. Tominaga, quick trigger. That's good from Keisei Tominaga. Cuts the Michigan lead to one.
A lot of scoring here early in this game, which is not something we've seen from the Wolverines, as they struggled to get a point within the first 4 minutes against Ohio State last Sunday. Nice to see them shooting well to start here.
Both these teams going back and forth. Burnett will rise on a three. That goes by Namuri Burnett. And both these teams are firing. Michigan is 3 of 3 from deep. They lead 11-7 after the Burnett triple. Here comes Williams around the handoff. Kicks, corner. On the drive, that's Alec. Layup is good, plus the harm. So Josiah Alec will head to the line for an old-fashioned three-point play.
Well, both teams are attacking. The defense has been casual, but both teams are attacking it. Michigan just looks calm, cool, and collected from behind the three-point line. Really playing like they have nothing to lose so far in the early stages of this game, which frankly they don't. Likely eliminated from NCAA March Madness contention unless they can have a miracle next week in the Big Ten tournament.
Winner of the Big Ten tournament automatically goes to the NCAA tournament. Alec made the free throw, so Michigan's lead is cut to one. It's 11-10. Cheddar right wing gets it back outside McDaniel. Now Williams swinging around. Burnett driving baseline. Picks up the dribble. Pivoting, gets it, Cheddar, elbow, jumper is good. Extends the lead to 3 for Michigan. It's 13-10, and the Wolverines are 5 of 6 from the field. Williams now right wing. He's guarded by Terrace Reed, tries to get it inside. Alec comes up with it, turns, layup is good. Those bigs are working in there for the Cornhuskers.
Beautiful drop step by Josiah Alec, just feeling the weight of the defender, dropping that pivot foot, and then laying it up right over the smaller defender.
Alec now switches on to Doug McDaniel. This is a matchup that Michigan likes. McDaniel swings, left wing Cheddar.
Made a three over him just a few minutes ago, Owen.
Burnett fires from the left wing. That one's no good. Probably not the best shot there. Contested three off the dribble. Nebraska comes up with it. It's Tominaga now. Right wing, gets a screen. Working baseline, rises, layup is good. Acrobatic finish. From Keisei Tominaga, Nebraska takes the lead. They're up one. It's 14-13.
How about the 6-2 Tominaga attacking the closeout, flying in the air and getting it to go. With just 13 more points, Owen, Tominaga can go to 1,000 points in Cornhusker history as Burnett can't get the three to go. Here's Nebraska on the break.
Definitely doable for Tominaga tonight. Nebraska now has it. Speaking of which, Tominaga fired from the top of the key. No good. Off the back heel. Rebound fought for, corralled by Doug McDaniel. Here comes the transition. McDaniel gets inside. Attacks, now brings it back outside. Now swings to Terrence Williams. Right wing gets it to Reed. Now hands to Burnett, who will work towards the middle. His pass is picked off by Bryce Williams, who's looking for Doug in the corner on a skip pass. Williams, good hands to pick it off, though. Rises on a wing three. That's no good. Rebound, Terrace Reed. So these teams have cooled off a bit shooting. Nebraska still leads by one. 15 to go in the first half. McDaniel thought about the three. Now gets it to Williams left wing. He fires and hits. Terrence Williams with his second three of the afternoon as Michigan regains the lead. It's 16-14.
What a nice shot by the senior on senior day. Terrence Williams got two threes to start today. And he's just provided a nice boost offensively, averaging just under 13 points per game for the Wolverines this season.
Williams lost it going up for the layup. Ball will stay with Nebraska. First media timeout of the afternoon. Shy, these teams have started off hot, especially in the opening couple of minutes. Now they've missed a couple shots since then. But still, Nebraska 6 of 9 from the field. Michigan 6 of 9 from the field. Michigan has hit four threes. Are these teams just hot, or is there something offensively that they're doing that's getting them these open looks?
Well, they're both kind of running a seven-second offense, so to speak, Owen. They want to get the ball down the court quickly, set it up. And the Michigan is running a lot of off-ball screens to their shooters, specifically Terrence Williams. Now, I don't know if that is something specific to trying to get him the ball on senior night, you know, trying to give the four-year Wolverine some more action on the scoreboard. But it's working. And I think they're being able to exploit some of the matchups they like. You mentioned the switches off the screens on Doug McDaniel, on Josiah Alec. And frankly, that might work. This is a very winnable game for the Wolverines, just to emphasize that. Nebraska in conference is 1-8. 1-8 in conference on the road this year. And Michigan, if I'm correct, is 18-0 in Ann Arbor against the Cornhuskers.
Wow. Working in Michigan's favor, certainly. You talk about this Nebraska team, Shy. This is a well-constructed team, but it's not super homegrown. Every starter played for a different school at some point in their career.
That's right.
But still, they seem to have this chemistry. They have a good balance of skill sets. What have you seen, not only in this first couple minutes that we've seen here at Chrysler, but throughout the season that's made Nebraska as successful as they've been? I mean, this is a team that historically has not a lot of success. This is the best year they've had under fifth-year head coach Fred Hoiberg. What have they been able to do this season that's gotten them over the hump?
Well, I think it comes with two things. I think it's being able to have the size to match up and have that switchability on defense. And, you know, it's hard to explain why they do so much better at Lincoln than they do on the road. But they hit the three really well, and I think offensively that's something that's often easier to do in your home stadium. And I think, as I said before, that combination of size to be able to have the offensive versatility to work it into those bigs, like Juwan Gary, like Alec, and be able to have those be kind of your safety valves offensively, but then also being able to space it out, dish out to the double teams with big men who can pass, and have those guards knock down threes allows for that offensive versatility to just win games consistently.
Back on the floor here, Tominaga will inbound baseline. Wiltshire has checked in for the Cornhuskers. Tominaga gets it back left wing, fires from three, it goes. Keisei Tominaga closing in on that 1,000-point mark. He's got 10 to go as Nebraska retakes the lead at 17-16 Cornhuskers. Jamarcus Lawrence has also checked in for the Cornhuskers. Michigan retains their starting five. McDaniel now right wing, guarded by Lawrence. Gets a high ball screen from Reed, picks up his dribble. Terrace thought about it. Now he steps back, free throw line jumper is no good. Hit the backboard and rimmed out. Tominaga running it up for Nebraska. Puts the ball on the deck, layup is good. Keisei Tominaga, another acrobatic finish. He is 8 away from 1,000 points. Nebraska is up by 3.
And as I was mentioning, Nebraska has a team with depth. That being said, Tominaga is the leader, averaging 14 points per game this season, and is their scorer when they need it the most.
McDaniel finds Reed on the inside, fires outside. Williams from the wing is no good. Rebound, Tominaga. Nebraska looking to get some momentum. Tominaga straight up three from 3 feet beyond. Keisei Tominaga. Are you not entertained? 22-16, his third three of the first half. Are you kidding?
That might have been 26 feet out, Owen, just absolutely no hesitation from Tominaga.
Williams puts the ball baseline, picks up his dribble. Outside, Burnett from the corner, no. Puts it on the ground, layup is good. He pump faked that one. Good response there from Burnett as the Michigan lead is, or the Nebraska lead, rather, is cut to four. But how about Tominaga? My goodness. He's 5 of 6 from the field, 3 of 4 from deep. He has it again. Tominaga picks up his dribble. It's Wilcher from the wing. That goes for C.J. Wilcher. And Nebraska is hitting from deep. That's their fourth three of the half. Both teams have 4 threes apiece. This is an entertaining one. It's 25-18, Nebraska leads. Very high-scoring game so far. McDaniel gets it. Cheddar up top, gets it inside. Reed foul is called. It'll go on Josiah Alec. It's the first foul of the afternoon for either team.
And so far, Tominaga's been the lift for Nebraska. This game feels close, but with those 13 points here early, with still 12:34 to go in the first half, Tominaga has given them that lift, and he's just been so elusive coming off those ball screens and just attacking the rim, very shifty.
That shot is so quick. He gets it off so quickly. It's hard for defenders to contest in an efficient manner. Williams now gets it. Right wing McDaniel. Tominaga has just checked out. Interesting move there by Hoiberg. Reed, high screen for McDaniel. Guarded by Sam Hoiberg. It's the coach's son is McDaniel. Hits a three from the right wing. Cuts the Nebraska lead to four. It's 25-21, Cornhuskers.
Well, looks like Doug McDaniel took a piece out of Keisei Tominaga's playbook off the one leg. Step back three. It's a ridiculous shot.
Quick trigger there for McDaniel as Mass gets the layup to go. So Michigan is scoring, but Nebraska's just responding. Cornhuskers are 11 of 14 from the field, 4 of 6 from deep. As Hoiberg hits the ground, we've got an offensive foul. It'll go on Terrace Reed Jr., another media timeout here. And Shy, last media timeout. We talk about how this game in the first couple of minutes, both these teams are firing, that they might have slowed down a bit. Well, they regain that steam right back. In large part thanks to Keisei Tominaga, who has just gone ballistic here in the first half. What is going on right now?
I think both teams are just shooting it well. And there's, you know, to start this game, there's a lot more ball movement. You're getting balls inside to Terrace Reed, into Mast for the Cornhuskers. And that was kind of looked like how this game was going to go, a lot more balance. Now it's the guards taking over, Owen. You have Doug McDaniel trying to show what he can do with the handle versus Tominaga just ripping it from three. This could be a battle of star guards here now, neither of which are hesitating to fire.
Oh, yeah. Tominaga hit 3 threes in the course of 4 minutes. He is 5 of 6 overall from the field, 3 of 4 from deep. Cornhuskers overall are 4 of 6 from deep, and Michigan's also scoring the ball. They're 8 of 13 from the field overall, 5 of 8 from downtown. But defensively for Michigan, it's been a struggle. Yes, Nebraska's hit some tough shots, but they've also had their way on the inside. They've had some good looks. Josiah Alec has had a couple. Rink Mass has had a couple easy layups. So, you know, it's not just that Nebraska is shooting well, but Michigan letting up a lot on the inside.
So sorry to cut you off, Owen. When it goes in from downtown, what these both sides are doing well is, we saw Namari Burnett do this a few times, attack the closeout. You know, these players are trying to help off drives, and then when they go to the closeout, both guards are doing a good job of getting to the basket, you know, because the defense is forced to spread itself out, which is why we're seeing so much scoring.
11:44 to go in the first half. It's been an energetic one, and it's Michigan's last game at the Crisler Center for this 2023-2024 regular season. Both these teams will play in the Big Ten tournament. Nebraska looking to gain a double bye in that tournament. Michigan will not have that luxury.
Michigan, in all likelihood, will be locked into that 14th seed, which will play Wednesday night on the 13th. They only have an abysmal 3 wins in conference, hoping to make this one the 4th to close out the regular season. But I think, you know, if you are Juwan Howard here, you not only have to look at this as a potential springboard for next season, assuming he returns, which speculation is that he will, it is, let's go get one in the Big Ten tournament. Even if we're not good enough to win, beat teams like Purdue later in the rounds, if you can make a splash here, that can say a lot in terms of recruiting and morale for this team.
We resume action here in Chrysler. Trey Jackson is checked in from Michigan, replacing Terrace Reed. Hoiberg picks up his dribble, gets the wheelchair. Up top, Williams swings it left wing. Now inside, it is Mast. A couple big dribbles. Here comes the double. Mast swings it corner. Hoiberg, and he traveled. He stepped out of bounds, rather. So Michigan will regain possession.
So they bring in Trey Jackson to try to 6'10 on 6'10 to match up against the size of Rank Mast. They still bring the double team of Terrence Williams a second. They get lucky with this, with stepping out of bounds on the corner.
McDaniel gets a high screen from Cheddar. Now gets it to Cheddar. Top of the key, 3 is up and no good. Rebound Trey Jackson, though, layup is good. So Jackson immediately makes an impact off the bench. Cuts the Cornhuskers lead to 4. It's 27-23 Nebraska.
Will Cheddar's the guy you want shooting that 3. 56% three-point shooter from behind the arc. Luckily there, Jackson gets the rebound and cleans the glass.
It looks like Michigan is in an amoeba-like 3-2 zone. Corner 3 is up and no good for Jamarcus Lawrence. Rebound Mast. Back outside. 3 from Wheelchair is up and no good. Rebound fought for, corralled by Terrence Williams. So here comes Michigan on offense. About halfway through this opening half. 10 minutes to go. 27-23 Nebraska. Jackson left wing. Thought about it. Brings it back out. Now it's McDaniel. Jalen Llewellyn at the scorer's table, prepping to check in for Michigan. McDaniel calling the shots up top. Gets a screen from Jackson. Now right wing. McDaniel down the lane. Throws up a floater. That is good off the backboard for Doug McDaniel. His patented floater as Wilcher hit the ground, and he's slow to get up.
But the body control from Doug just to shake off being hounded by Hoiberg and just get that up with the right hand.
Wilcher hands Hoiberg. 3 is up and good there for Rink Mass. 35% from beyond the arc this season. The big fella showing that he can shoot the rock. Nebraska up 5.
Well, with the way this game has been going, that's probably who you want shooting the rock right now.
Back up top, McDaniel. It's a high screen from Cheddar. He slipped it, though. Ball went through his hands, found its way to Jackson, who drives baseline for the slam. Cuts that Nebraska lead to 3. It's 30-27. Nebraska quickly up top. Hoiberg, corner. Bounces inside. Lawrence puts it up, puts it in.
Well, both teams just seem to be making the right offensive play, and everything just seems to be going right offensively as the Wolverines, that last play, trying to get it in to Cheddar on the free throw line, goes through.
McDaniel.
McDaniel's is pickpocketed here. Yep. Mask has it now. He has a Jokic-like pass down the court.
Wilcher now. Inside, Cheddar working hard defensively. Picks up his dribble. Michigan bench wants to travel. Pass is picked off. Here comes Terrence Williams down the court. Nebraska leads by 5. Williams crosses over, rises. No whistle again for T-Will. He is flabbergasted. It's the second play that Williams is wanting to whistle, and he hasn't gotten one. Down the lane, Lawrence, no good. Rebound fought for. Ball is still inbounds. Now it's out of bounds, and it goes to Michigan. A hectic 30 seconds there.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like both teams are moving fast, and it was working really well for them. All of a sudden, the last, like, 4 possessions, very sloppy, and that can happen when you're getting into your half-court sets within 3 to 4 seconds. So now, hopefully, the Wolverines will just try to slow it down a little bit as Jalen Llewellyn comes in for Doug McDaniel, providing him some relief. with around 8:30 to go in this first half.
Terrence Reed is also back in. Terrence Williams now drives baseline, rises mid-range, is no good off the heel. Tominaga also back in. He gets the rebound. 32-27 Nebraska, approaching 8 to go in the first half. Tominaga gets right by Llewellyn and scores.
How about the speed of Tominaga? Just blows right by the squared-up base of Llewellyn. Nothing he can really do.
Jackson, right corner, fires a three. That one is long. Rebound fought for. Llewellyn fouled Tominaga. Kind of push him to the side like a defensive end in football. The ref said that's not allowed. We'll go to immediate timeout. Nebraska will have the ball when we return. We're just inside 8 minutes here. Tominaga has checked back in. This game is moving fast. It's hectic. These teams, from an efficiency standpoint, have kind of reeled it back a bit, but the intensity remains, Shaq.
Absolutely. I mean, we saw that swim move from Llewellyn to try to get the rebound over Tominaga. But absolutely, the intensity does remain. Michigan has not backed down in this game, in a game where they easily very well could have. Nebraska clearly has a lot to play for, looking to try to clinch that double bye in the Big Ten tournament. But Michigan is trying to fight defensively, but right now they don't have an answer for the speed of Tominaga.
Nebraska in that upper tier of Big Ten basketball right now. They sit at fourth in the Big Ten, a very competitive Big Ten. They're 11-8 in conference. Wisconsin is also 11-8. Nebraska has the tiebreaker over them. Northwestern is 12-8. Then you've got Illinois at 13-6. They're second in the conference. And then the Purdue Boilermakers at 16-3. They sit atop of the Big Ten standings. Michigan, for sure, will finish as the last seed. So, like you said, Shai, it'll take a miracle for Michigan to win the Big Ten tournament, but there's still basketball to play for them. So their season is not over, regardless of what happens after this game.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's the way you have to look at it if you're the Wolverines internally. Every game is an opportunity. And if you're able to play free like the way they are and just stay in these games and compete, you're going to have a shot. This is Big Ten basketball. It's a very, very competitive conference. But this team has some talent. You know, you lose Olivier Kama to wrist surgery a few weeks ago. He was their second leading scorer, averaging around 15 points per game. But they've had contributions from Terrence Reed Jr. playing more minutes. Terrence Williams the second getting more looks offensively. And, of course, we know what Doug McDaniel can do. If those three guys can step up and move the ball around, they can play, and they can play as a team. They can win a game or two in the Big Ten tournament, and that's really all you need. You get one win. They have not won since February 7th. If they can get one win, that's all it can take in this tournament.
It's been a while since Michigan looking to end the regular season on any moderately high note that they can. As we return to the floor here in Crisler, it's 34-27, Nebraska leads. Just under 8 minutes to go in the opening half. I want to thank Alex Miller for running our score bug for our WCBN YouTube page. Thank you for tuning in this Sunday afternoon. As we return to the floor, it's Jamarcus Lawrence who will take it up for the Cornhuskers, guarded by Trey Jackson. Michigan went to that zone briefly, but they're now back in man. Up top, Williams, hands to Hoiberg around the screen. Mass now guarded by Terrence Reed, top of the key. Tominaga gets the handoff, bounces it into Mass. Wide open three from the corner. Lawrence is no good, left it short. Rebound is corralled by Trey Jackson. Yusuf Kayat has checked into the game for the Michigan Wolverines as well. So it's Llewellyn, McDaniel, Reed Jr., Jackson, and Kayat. Llewellyn will hand to McDaniel left wing. Working middle, back to Llewellyn on the left wing, looking to go inside to Terrence Reed. Nebraska's in a, looks like they're in man, actually. Kayat on the cut, picks up his dribble, foul is called, will be on Mass. Nice pump fake there by Yusuf.
And a good pass from Llewellyn. Interesting choice from Juwan Howard earlier to go into that amoeba-like zone, as you called it, considering how well Nebraska was shooting it from the three-point line, probably realizing that wasn't such a smart decision going back to man to match with the Cornhuskers.
Llewellyn will inbound baseline for Michigan, gets it to Reed, who hands to Jackson up top. Now Llewellyn left wing. Guarded closely there by Jamarcus Lawrence. Llewellyn gets a ball screen from Jackson, pulls it back out, guarded by Tominaka. Llewellyn, five on the shot clock, inside. Floater is up and no good, but a whistle is blown. So Jalen Llewellyn will head to the line for two, attempting to cut this Nebraska lead to five.
That's the right idea from Llewellyn, attacking Tominaga. He has the size, and you know Tominaga, known for being a very good scorer, not always the most prolific defender on the perimeter. So smart by Llewellyn to attack. He'll go to the free throw line through two, missing the first one.
First free throw is off the heel. Llewellyn just under 65% from the stripe this season. Second free throw is up and good, so the lead is cut to six. It's 34-28, Cornhuskers. Hoiberg, far left wing, guarded by Llewellyn. It's a screen from Tominaga, now masked up top. Fires inside Hoiberg, skied to catch it. Ball finds its way to Juwan Gary, who flips it up and in. Acrobatic playing here from Nebraska. Hoiberg went way up to catch that pass from Mast, and Hoiberg only stands at 6 feet. Good job to get it, and to get it to Gary. Michigan on offense now. McDaniel puts it on the ground, fires. Jackson left wing, puts it on the ground, rises, whistle is blown. So Trey Jackson will head to the line.
Again, a good job by Trey Jackson to attack the closeout. Not the most common thing to do as a big man, but the physicality is what you want to see from the Michigan Wolverines. Parents on the second made a similar move earlier in the game, did not get a call. There, the officials thought there was just enough contact.
That's the second foul on a rink, Mast. It's definitely something to watch for, as he will check out for Josiah Alec. Mast is the Cornhuskers' second leading scorer at 12.8 points on the season, and he's by far their leading rebounder at just under 8 per game. So that's definitely something to look for as this game progresses. Jackson makes both free throws. Lead is cut to 6 as Michigan brings out a 2-2-1 full court press. We'll see how much they commit to this as Nebraska easily breaks it. Hoiberg now gets inside, fires back outside. Tominaga left open, pump face gets inside. Floater is up and good, but a travel is going to be called. Tominaga doesn't like the call.
That's a good call. Drags his pivot foot, trying to just step through there for the defender, and just couldn't quite get it past the officials.
Llewellyn back up top for the Wolverines, gets it to Reed, right elbow. Hands to Kayat down the lane, floater is up and good off the backboard for Yusuf Kayat. Williams now pulls it back outside, guarded by Kayat, who's hounding him. Corner now, Gary drives baseline. Tried to find Kase in the other corner. Got tipped out of bounds by Terrace Reed. So a jolt of energy from Michigan as the Nebraska lead only sits at 4. We've got 5.5 to go in the first half. Bryce Williams will inbound baseline. Gets it to Tominaga, who rises. Left-handed layup is good. Right over Doug McDaniel as Tominaga flexes the biceps to let Doug know it's 38-32 Nebraska.
17 now for Tominaga. One more point will get into 1,000 in his Cornhuskers career.
Reed now hands Kayat down the lane, hands McDaniel right wing, steps back, still has it. Jackson up top, pivots, now gets it inside Reed. We have a offensive foul on Terrace Reed. You saw Josiah Alec kind of bend over a little bit like he got hit. I think Reed might have caught him there with the elbow. Ball will go back to Nebraska.
Yeah, just an inadvertent move from T. Reed there, trying to just gather space. That arm expands back as he catches the ball and trying to shield it, and just catches probably a little bit of Alex's chin as he's making that catch. It's a good call from the official.
Williams will take it up for the Cornhuskers. He has it left wing. It's a high screen from Gary. Now Alec right elbow. Puts it on the ground. Here comes Gary down the lane. Right-handed layup is up and good. Through the contact, Juwan Gary capitalizes, and Nebraska's up by 8. It's 40-32 Cornhuskers. McDaniel up top, guarded by Hoiberg. Jackson now left wing. Shedder top of the key. Looking McDaniel left wing, quick trigger is up, and good for Doug McDaniel, a couple feet beyond the arc. As he keeps Michigan in it, they're down only five. Tominaga now for 1,000 points, and he hit it. Keisei Tominaga has scored 1,000 in his Nebraska career as he drills his patented three, as we will go to a timeout. And the Nebraska bench is congratulating him. Wow, that was quick, that was impressive, and what other way to hit the mark than with Keisei Tominaga, a straightaway quick trigger three. As we like to welcome you into our broadcast cam here at WCBN. Got a media timeout. Keisei Tominaga just hit the 1,000-point mark in his Nebraska Cornhusker career. What better way to do it, Shy, than with a patented quick trigger three?
No better way, and that's his game. You know, not to compare him to one of the greats in Steph Curry, but he plays like it a little bit offensively. That quick movement off the ball and quick snap of the wrist from beyond the arc with the left hand makes him very hard to defend. Doug McDaniel's been trying to do his best to keep up the scoring load for the Wolverines. He's got 11 to Tominaga's 20 as Michigan trails Nebraska 35 to 43 with just over 4 minutes to go in this first half. But I think if you're Michigan, you've got to try to slow this game down a little bit. Nebraska has been trying to move it fast. I think if you're Juwan Howard, I'm telling his guys to slow it down, make that entry feed in to Terrace Reed, and just try to, you know, have a little bit of a post game, maybe kick it out if you need to. But I think that's going to help slow down this tempo and get Michigan some positive exchanges of possession to go into halftime.
It's definitely been a high-scoring affair for both teams here as Nebraska leads by 8-43-35, just inside 4.5 minutes to go in the opening half. Senior night here at Chrysler, Michigan's final game of the regular season. Keisei Tominaga, the senior guard for Nebraska, just eclipsed the 1,000-point mark from Moriyama, Japan, on the center southern part of the island. Tominaga played 2 years of community college ball at Ranger College, that's in Texas, before transferring over to Nebraska, where he's been a staple of the program, and he's led the Cornhuskers to their best season and their only winning season since 2018-2019. So he's a special presence down in Lincoln for this program as we return to the floor to close out this first half. And an energetic one it's been. Both teams are 6 of 11 from beyond the arc. McDaniel for Michigan is perfect from the field. 4 of 4 overall, 3 of 3 of which have been from downtown. McDaniel now gets it left wing. Quickly goes to the center. Williams the second now right wing. Gets it back to McDaniel up top by the logo. Llewellyn now left wing, looking to go inside, and he does. The Cheddar short corner. Here comes a double team from Nebraska. McDaniel left wing now gets it to Williams. Fires corner. Llewellyn puts it on the ground. Now fires left wing. McDaniel open from three. Pump fakes. Fires one up, and it goes for Doug McDaniel. That's his fourth three of the first half as the Michigan lead, Nebraska lead rather, is cut to five. It's 43-38 Cornhuskers.
And Doug McDaniel's been doing a great job shooting it as well. Nice shifty pump fake before letting it fly from beyond the arc.
Tominaga, that one is short. Wiltshire gets the rebound though. Now Llewellyn comes up with it after the strip. Michigan a chance to get right back in it here. Llewellyn pull up three is no good. Rebound Tominaga, gotta keep an eye out for him. He's pushing it down the court. Kayat picks him up. Tominaga down the lane, left-handed layup is no good. Foul is called. Tough call there. Went right into Kayat. And Yusuf doesn't like the call.
Yeah, and I don't blame him. He's trying to do his best to keep Tominaga in front of him. Tominaga going to that patented left hand and just does a pretty good acting job of getting pushed off his spot, supposedly, by Kayat, or so the officials think. Tominaga will look to add to his 20-point scoring total right here with a trip to the line for two.
First free throw for Tominaga is no good. It rimmed out to the joy of Michigan fans around the arena. Tomi Naga, 87% from the line. That's a rare miss from the senior. Second free throw is good. So lead extends to 6 for Nebraska. It's 44-38. Approaching 3 minutes to go in what's been an electrifying opening half. McDaniel up top. It's a high ball screen from Cheddar working right. Now Williams, the second left wing, guarded closely by Gary. Back up to McDaniel. Makes a move. Drives down the lane. Throws at the floater. That is up and no good. Hit the back of the rim and rolled out. Williams now pushing it. Hands to Gary. Alec now inside. Gets fouled by Llewellyn. So Nebraska will take it out baseline.
And if you just look at this Nebraska offense, it has depth to it. You know, nice dribble handoff into the pick and roll. Alec with the nice roll and giving Llewellyn no choice but to foul the large senior from Lincoln.
Tomi Naga quick trigger is good as he hits the deck. That was inside the arc, two-pointer for Kese. He is 9 of 11. He's got 23 points in the opening half. McDaniel. It's two screens, one from Cheddar, one from Williams. Fires inside to Cheddar, who gets it in. What a pass there from Doug McDaniel to see Will Cheddar open for a split second, and he found him in perfect timing.
Snake eyes with the right hand just whips it down to the low block, and Cheddar does the rest.
Williams drives and is fouled by Cheddar. Michigan fans not liking this officiating as Bryce Williams will head to the line for two.
Michigan might need to change their defensive strategy a little bit. Nebraska now going to the rim almost every time. As before, earlier in this half, they were letting it fly from deep. Maybe time to just protect the basket a little bit more, not close out quite as hard, just to give themselves a cushion to stay in front of these sharp and fast Nebraska guards.
Williams missed the first free throw. Second also missed, left it short, rebound Burnett, who was newly checked in. So Michigan with an opportunity to cut this lead to 3 or 4. Got 2 minutes to go in the opening half. High ball screen comes from Cheddar. McDaniel working right. Gets it to Burnett right wing. Now Williams right corner. Back outside Burnett. Guarded by Tomi Naga. 10 on the shot clock. Burnett working off a Cheddar screen. Fires now to McDaniel. Left corner. Up and good from Doug McDaniel. His performance has kind of been overlooked because of Keisei Tomi Naga, but McDaniel has 5 threes in the opening half, 6 of 7 from the field overall, 17 points in Michigan. Right back in this game, it's 46-43 Nebraska. Alec now from the free throw line, looking for somewhere to go with it, gets it inside. Wilcher, layup is good. CJ Wilcher, tough finish over two Michigan defenders. That Nebraska lead is right back up to 5. Inside a minute and a half to go in the opening half. Burnett picks up his dribble, turns it over, throws it right to Tomi Naga. Kind of lost his balance. So we'll see if Nebraska can extend that lead. Tomi Naga down the lane, flips it up, left it short. Rebound fought for and corralled by McDaniel. Got a minute to go in the opening half. McDaniel will slow it down a little bit. It's 48-43 Nebraska. Keisei Tomi Naga, 23 points, 9 of 12. Doug McDaniel, 17 points, 6 of 7. Cheddar rises on the jumper, no good off the heel. Rebound Tomi Naga. Less than a minute to go in the opening half. Tomi Naga guarded by Burnett. Now Kayat steps up on him. Williams left wing. Looking for Alec on the inside. He gets it to him. Right on the elbow. Alec makes a move on Cheddar. Cheddar staying with him. Alec, couple long steps and the layup goes. Good move there from Josiah Alec. We've got 33 seconds left in the opening half. So Nebraska will get at least a 2 second possession, regardless of what happens here. McDaniel taking his sweet time just beyond half court. At 14 on the shot clock, 50-43 Nebraska leads. Here comes a double high ball screen, and we've got a foul called, and that is going to be on Bryce Williams.
Just to appreciate some of this guard play that we're seeing, Doug McDaniel's on pace for 34 now. in this game versus Toenaga on pace for 46. And McDaniel, so shifty on the ball, but Toenaga doing a great job off of it, which is even harder to defend.
6 seconds, McDaniel. He gets it left wing. 3-2. McDaniel fires it up, and no good. And Burnett the follow, though, and he gets the layup to go. We'll see if it counted. The far side ref says it doesn't. That looked awfully close, though.
Certainly close. To me, it looked like he barely did not get it off. But, of course, they will review as Crisler Center anxiously takes a look at this replay.
Can't see the clock from that angle. We will get a review here, though. So 50-43 the score for now. We'll see if they count the bucket. Regardless, that was an electrifying, high-scoring first half characterized by uncanny guard play. You're talking about Keisei Tominaga, 23 in the opening half. Doug McDaniel with 17. Shy, what an electric way to end out this regular season, at least for the first half for both these teams.
Absolutely, and frankly, it gives these fans at Crisler Center that have not had a very happy year, particularly February and early March, an entertaining game. 50-43. Now that is high scoring for Big Ten college basketball. And, you know, I think it's hard to completely account for why the shooting and why these offenses have been so successful to start this game. But yeah, you're right. It has to start with this guard play. They're opening up opportunities for others, attacking the basket. That Doug McDaniel's patented step back one-legged shot versus that Tominaga quick trigger off the ball release has just been absolutely masterful to watch so far.
Now, like you said, Shy, Nebraska can't really afford to lose this game. They've had a very consistent regular season. They're undefeated both in quad three and in quad four. And for those listeners that don't know what that means, college basketball is divided into four quads. That's the term. And these quads are looked at when considering a team for the NCAA tournament as an at-large bid for a team that doesn't win their conference tournament. In Nebraska, and you want to win your quad three and quad four, that's the bottom half of college basketball. You want to win all those games. Nebraska is a combined 14-0 in both of those quads. Michigan is certainly a quad four team.
Yes.
So Nebraska doesn't want this loss here. Nebraska 4-7 in quad one, 3-2 in quad two. Like you said, Shy, I mean, this is a big game for Nebraska. It's an important motivational game for Nebraska going into the Big Ten tournament. They're up by 7, but this game is far from over.
Absolutely, and Michigan has the chance to play spoiler here for a Big Ten rival. Nebraska have looked probably the best they've looked offensively on the road so far this season, and, you know, if you've been watching this game, you know why. It's due to Keisei Tominaga and that really good supporting cast that average it. They have four players who average over double figures on the season. They have good depth. But I think for Nebraska to kind of maintain this offensive onslaught and kind of put away the Wolverines, so to speak, it's going to be about taking pressure off of Tominaga. The reality is, as good as he is, likely Michigan will try to make adjustments. Double team off the ball, deny him those passes, and try to make guys like Lawrence or Gary, maybe even Mass, potentially beat them. And Nebraska knows those guys are more than capable of doing that. The question is, will they make that choice in order to prevent Keisei Tominaga from potentially having a 45-point or even 50-point game, who knows, at this rate against them?
50-43 Nebraska leads. We just hit halftime here in Chrysler as Michigan closes out their regular season. We've had some terrific guard play. Keisei Tominaga for Nebraska hit the 1,000-point mark in his Cornhusker career. Doug McDaniel has 17 overall in the first half. This has been an electrifying first half. For Michigan, what can they do? What can they continue to do, really, to come out on top in this second half? They've got some work to do. They've played well offensively, albeit it's mostly been Doug McDaniel. What can they do defensively? I mean, we talked about earlier in the game how while you do close out on those threes, Nebraska's doing a great job of pump faking, driving, and moving the ball to get inside for layups. What can Michigan do defensively? They tried the zone for a possession. They tried to press for a possession. They largely abandoned both of those things and stuck with the man defense. Should they continue doing that? What should their strategy be?
Well, I think it's important to mix it up. And I think maybe that's what Juwan Howard was trying to do earlier in this game. But maybe you do mix in some of that 2-3 zone just to kind of not let the speed of Tominaga and some of these guards kill you as much as they try to get to the basket, and then going back to man to try to prevent some of those three-point opportunities. And I think it's just about denying Tominaga the ball ultimately, whether that's bringing two on him as soon as he gets it, forcing the ball out of his hands. But the reality is, if you do that, you've got to be able to bring in size, and Trey Jackson and Terrace Reed, let's see if they go on the floor at the same time, which they haven't so far this game, just to kind of make sure that, you know, because Tominaga can pass too, try to make sure that those Nebraska guards don't work it into them for easy dunks and easy points.
Certainly. We talked about Michigan before the game. What would their strategy be? Would they switch it up? Would they experiment for their last game of the regular season? I think they've largely stuck to what they've been doing all season. Now, Yusuf Kayat has played, but remember, like you said earlier, Olivier Kamwa is out, so Michigan needs that front court depth, and Kayat has done a pretty good job, I would say. 1-of-1 from the field. He's also gotten assists. He's played hard. Do you think Michigan brings in some new guys, George Washington maybe, or do they stick with the eight-man rotation that they've been employing here in the first half?
Well, when we were seeing George Washington get minutes, it was when Doug McDaniel was facing that academic suspension on the road, and they were kind of having to give Jalen Llewellyn big minutes off of his ACL injury, which made sense. But largely, for the freshmen, it's probably a lot to handle, and the way the intensity of this game has gone, you're probably going to err away from that, if I had to guess, if you're Juwan Howard. But, you know, back to Yo-Yo Kayat, this is a guy that they like a lot in the locker room, a capable three-point shooter, someone who's getting more comfortable off the dribble as well. And you said it, a motor guy who can just play hard on defense. We saw him, you know, get called for a couple fouls that he was frustrated about, but that's the type of physical intensity and size that you want when you go up against such a potent offensive team like Nebraska.
Just inside 10 minutes to go in halftime. Thank you for tuning in to WCBN Sports and our final regular season men's broadcast. I'm Owen Klein, joined by the wonderful Shai Dweck. We've got Alex Miller and Gavin Briggs on deck for the second half. It should be a good one. So we're going to transition over here shortly if them two are ready. Again, it's been a pleasure calling this first half with you. It's been a pleasure really calling Michigan basketball. For me, this is my final broadcast for the men's team. I want to thank you to WCBN for giving me this platform. It's been a wonderful club, a staple of my college career. This has been nothing short of fantastic for me, and I want to give big thanks to Michigan Athletics for being the powerhouse that they are, being able to provide these opportunities for students like myself. And with that, I'm going to sign off. Lovey says farewell as we transition over to the second half for Alex Miller and Gavin Briggs-Shai. Thank you. It's been a great call, sir.
Always a pleasure sharing the airtime with you, Owen.
Oh, yeah. All right, we're going to transition over.
Hello, everyone, and welcome in to your second half coverage on WCBN Sports. I'm Alex Miller. Alongside me, Gavin Briggs, for what should be a fun first half. This one is close, 50 Nebraska, 43 Michigan so far. The Cornhuskers have lit it up on offense. Casey Tominaga has given his team something special. Doug McDaniel has given Michigan something special on the other end. Gavin, first thoughts, what'd you see there in the first half?
Michigan's defense has been lacking a little bit. Keisei Tominaga has had as many looks as he wants, especially from three. Nebraska shooting 70% in that first half, just Nebraska scoring at will from three inside. But Michigan has done a great job of coming back on the other side and shooting the lights out on their own.
I mean, if you look at these numbers, Nebraska is at 70% from the field, 50% from three, 6 for 12. And Michigan on the other side, no slackers, 55 from the field, 53% from three. And that brings us to this ball game where we're at 50-43 Cornhuskers at the half. As I believe a proposal was just shown on the Jumbotron, and it's as loud as it's been all day in Crisler.
One interesting stat looking at this game is not a lot of rebounds. You know, when both teams are shooting this well, neither team will really get a lot of rebounds, and there's not been a big difference between the two. Nebraska only with 13, Michigan with 10. Low numbers at the half.
Yeah, so far in this one, offense definitely the story. And I'm looking forward to a fun second half to round out this season. And we can talk a little bit about this. Michigan this season, it has not been a season I think most would have expected or wanted. Michigan was projected to finish 11th in the Big Ten. They're going to finish 14th, mm-hmm. of 14. And certainly not what you want from this program. And it's been a very up and down season. I mean, starting early in the season, there were reasons for optimism. A crushing win in New York against St. John's, a couple other upset wins early. Even later in the year, there was an upset win over Wisconsin in this very building. But overall, throughout the season, you're 8-22, you're 3-16, and you're staring off at everyone in the Big Ten.
Yes. Michigan, as you said, they had some good wins to start it out. Back in New York, that loss to Long Beach State was kind of that first blow to this season. And they've had some good competitive games in between, but just have sometimes struggled to win when it comes down to the final stretch.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this team has really struggled in the second half at times, and they've really struggled to close out games. And if you're Michigan, you want to end the season on a high. Why not go out on a win over a team in Nebraska that is currently sitting at fourth in the Big Ten? They're trying to hold on to a double bye going into the Big Ten tournament. They're a team that has struggled on the road this year. I believe they're still undefeated at home in Big Ten play. And if you're Michigan, you have an opportunity to go out with a win over a good Big Ten program. But no matter how you slice it, this has not been a great team this year. This is likely a season you want to forget if you're in the Michigan program, if you're a Michigan fan.
Yes, definitely not one to remember, but a win here would be nice, especially the you know, maybe get yourself a little bit of momentum, go into the Big Ten tournament, maybe steal a game from someone, knock them out early.
That would be fun.
Would definitely give just a little bit of excitement to end the year.
No doubt. I mean, a couple of us were talking the other day about what if this team went on a run in the Big Ten tournament and secured the auto bid. I think that would be one of the greatest turnarounds in NCAA basketball history, but I don't foresee that, but that would be fun.
It would definitely be very fun. Great way to end the year, but you know, come in with a win here and an unfortunate loss next year an unfortunate loss going into the first round of the Big Ten tournament. It would be all right if we could just, you know, get something good, get some positives heading into the offseason and into next year.
Absolutely. So we're about 2 minutes away from getting back underway here for the second half. Running through the stats, Doug McDaniel has been everything for Michigan. He's got 17, 6 for 8, 5 for 6 from downtown. And the only miss was a late heave at the buzzer at the end of the second half. 5 for 5 otherwise. No one else in double figures. Trey Jackson has 6 off the bench. Terrence Williams, 6 in the starting lineup. Namari Burnett with 5. Will Cheddar with 4. And a couple others. Terrace Reed with 2. Yusuf Kayat with 2. Will Cheddar with 4. Jalen Llewellyn with a bucket himself. But it should be fun. It's hoping for a ball game. We've got one. Michigan within 7. They'll look to cut into it as we get started in the second half. A minute 30 left here in halftime. And just want to mention it one time here is on Wednesday of next week is Giving Blue Day, a big fundraiser for the University of Michigan and for this very station. And we will on Wednesday have a link available to donate to WCBN Sports. And while we very do much appreciate you all listening more than anything, it does mean a lot to the station for donations. It helps us travel. It helps us replace if we have any broken headsets or soundboards. It really keeps us going as a station, and we'd really appreciate you consider donating. So with that said, we're almost back underway here. 50-43, Cornhuskers in the first. It was a fun one. Both teams shot the lights out. Keisei Tominaga was in one of those zones for Nebraska. Doug McDaniel, the answer's the other way for Michigan. I mean, Gavin, if you're Michigan looking at the second half, I imagine at halftime what they've been chatting about is how do you get stops against Nebraska right now?
100%. I think the defensive matchups have been interesting. I think you really need to focus on containing Keisei Tominaga while keeping a check on those post players in Mast and Alec for Nebraska. I think if you do key in too much on that three-point line, they may get some easy buckets on the inside. But, yeah, definitely we'll need to step it up on the defensive end and keep those guards in check.
All righty, so we'll get back underway here on the court for Nebraska. They'll roll with their starters, Keisei Tominaga, Bryce Williams, Jawan Gary, Josiah Alec, and the big man Rink Mast in the middle. Jamarcus Lawrence started the first 23 games of the season for this team, effectively at point guard. He's come off the bench for the last 7 as Nebraska's elected to go with this lineup with Jawan Gary at the 3. He's essentially a third big. They'll rarely have less than 2 of Mast, Alec, and Gary on the floor, and they elect to start with all 3 of them as of late. For Michigan, their starters take the floor. Doug McDaniel, Namari Burnett, Terrence Williams the 2nd, Terrace Reed Jr. in the middle, and Will Cheddar, who's in there, of course, for the injured Olivier Kamwa. Michigan awaiting the Cornhusker inbound, already somewhat lined up in a 2-3 zone. We'll see if that's just for show or if the Wolverines stick with it. They went to zone a little bit in the first half. I feel like throughout this season, the zone has largely struggled. Nebraska also a team that has some zone breakers that can shoot the lights out from downtown. Tominaga, C.J. Wilcher off the bench has been unbelievably efficient this season. He's at 40% from 3, and Bryce Williams is a solid shooter, but we'll see how the Wolverines go. Inbound to Bryce Williams. He'll walk it up on the left wing, and it gets a screen from Josiah Alec. Now over to Tominaga on the other wing. Back to Williams. Top of the key, matched up with McDaniel. Rink Mask comes and gets it on the left side. Driving on Will Cheddar. Back to the basket. Mask posting up Cheddar. Leaner fade away with the hook. That one's off. Josiah Alec tips it up. Terrence Williams, the 2nd, corrals it for Michigan. Terrence will push the other way. He's going to get a double screen moving to his left. Pulls up at the elbow. T. Will comes up short. Rink Mass the rebound.
You had talked about that 2-3 zone, and Michigan did start with that coming out. Looks back now to man, but that zone did work for that first possession.
Tominaga with a cut to the bucket and gets 2 for Nebraska. He continues what has been a phenomenal day thus far. 52-43. Cornhuskers. Doug McDaniel with a screen to his right. Bounce pass into Terrace Reed. 1 dribble. Trying to work through Rink Mass. Puts it up strong and finishes. Terrace Reed Jr. in the post. Gets 2 for Michigan. 52-45. Tominaga from way downtown comes up short. Alec on the follow. Josiah Alec came swooping in from the corner and with a pretty finish with one hand. 54-45. Doug McDaniel, pocket pass to Terrace Reed Jr. Terrace takes the mid-range jumper. Nothing but the left side of the glass. That one was not particularly close for the Michigan big, and it goes out of bounds off of Michigan.
That Terrace Reed with a second mid-range shot of the day. Both, unfortunately, not going in. But he's been a little more aggressive as of late shooting as opposed to earlier on in the year.
Tominaga skip pass to Jawan Gary. Gary puts up a tough floater. That one's off. Will Cheddar the rebound for Michigan. Now Doug McDaniel will bring it up. Meant by Tominaga. Gets a screen from T-Will. T-Will pops open on the left wing. He puts up a three. Terrence Williams the second knocks it down.
It's his third three on the day. Three for four.
Terrence Williams the second has shot it well. Jawan Gary on a back cut puts it up over Terrence Williams. And they'll call a foul on Terrence Williams. So 54-48 Nebraska with 18 to go here. And Jawan Gary will shoot a pair at the charity stripe. Jawan Gary has been such a key cog for this Nebraska team all year. First free throw is short off the front iron as what he brings defensively, and he's at times shot it well from the three-point line, and it's just a guy that brings the attitude and the effort that Fred Hoiberg wants from his squad. Second free throw, he rattles it home. Front rim, back rim, side of the rim, and drops on in. 55-48 Michigan, under 18 to play here in the second half. Michigan looking to cut into the seven-point deficit. Terrace Reed Jr., dribble handoff to Namari Burnett coming to his left. Swings it to Terrence Williams, now a screen from Terrace Reed. Swings it to Maury Burnett off a pin down from the corner. It's blocked. Josiah Alec closed out quickly and got a piece of it. Bryce Williams now the other way. Loses his dribble and slows down a bit. Rink Mast top of the key. Now Gary on the right wing. Matched up with Doug McDaniel. Over to Rink Mast. Enters the post to Williams. Working on Namari Burnett. Williams fakes a fadeaway. Now steps through with a left hand. A finger roll. Rattles it home. Fancy footwork for Bryce Williams. And he gets the deuce. 57-48 Cornhuskers. Amari Burnett on the right wing. Has Josiah Alec. Likes that matchup. Now goes post to Cheddar. Matched up with Tominaga. Mast comes with the double. Over to McDaniel. Extra pass. Terrence Williams wide open left wing. Off the iron. Josiah Alec rips away the rebound. Will Cheddar couldn't hold on. And Alec took it away from him. Both teams playing in a hurry. Mast pump fakes the three. Now slows it down to Bryce Williams. Working on Will Cheddar. Williams, step back three, comes up short. Jawan Gary, second try, out to Tominaga. Tominaga resets it to Bryce Williams. Screen from Rink Mast. Williams going downhill. Now Alec in the corner, driving past Terrace Reed and scoops it in with a left hand. A pretty take from Josiah Alec. And Jawan Howard has seen enough. Takes the timeout, 59-48. Cornhuskers on a little bit of a run here from Ann Arbor in the Crisler Center.
You know, in this run, it's kind of started on the defensive end. Nebraska running a similar defense as they did in the first half, doubling in the post in the corner when either Cheddar or Reed get the ball in the block. They kind of push him out more towards the corner, and it forces the swing. Michigan capitalized on a couple of those swing passes for threes early on, but so far in the second half has struggled.
And overall, Nebraska just really cognizant of their personnel. Like we saw there, Cheddar got a switch and had Tominaga on him in the post. And as soon as he caught the pass, Rink Mast was there with the double because he knows Tominaga is not a great matchup for Cheddar in the post with the size disadvantage there. And that's smart help defense from the Cornhuskers. And, I mean, perhaps that defensive execution is one of the reasons Nebraska is fourth in the conference and Michigan down at 14th. Cornhuskers still sitting over 65% from the field, 43% from downtown. Keisei Tominaga has 25. And Josiah Alec has 11. He had a couple nice takes. Really nice follow on a miss during that last sequence of plays.
Nebraska, especially coming out, starting in the second half, they've been really good about being aggressive on the offensive glass and have gotten a few really big rebounds that have led to second chance possessions for them.
16:27 to go here from the Crisler Center. Cornhuskers 59, Wolverines 48. So the Wolverines trail by 11 as they look to cut into this lead. Juwan Howard took a timeout to talk it over with the Michigan men. Michigan wearing the all yellows, the all maize, I should say, today. In their final game of the regular season. So we'll get back underway. Thanks for tuning in to WCBN Sports, the official student voice of Michigan Athletics. I'm Alex Miller. Alongside me, Gavin Briggs, Owen Klein, and Chai Dweck in an excellent first half on the mic. We'll get back underway here. Will Cheddar will be inbounding to McDaniel. And Michigan keeping the starters on the floor. Namari Burnett, Terrence Williams II, and Terrace Reed join McDaniel and Cheddar. Cornhuskers have Williams, Alec, Rink Mask, Juwan Gary, and Keisei Tominaga. Their starters still in. McDaniel will walk it up. Here come the Wolverines. Terrace Reed hits a pin down for Terrence Williams II. He comes up and gets it from McDaniel. Namari Burnett off an off-ball screen gets a handoff from T-Will. Swings it to Cheddar. One more to Terrence Williams. Drives past Alex. Step through in the lane. Kick out to Namari. One more to Doug McDaniel from the corner. Just short. Cheddar on the follow. Puts it up and in. That was a beautiful possession for Michigan there.
Yeah, great possession. Swinging the ball all the way around. All four, if not all five, offensive players touched the ball there on that possession.
Tominaga comes off an off-ball screen. Now leaves it for Rink Mast. Mast up top. Hand off to Bryce Williams. Oh, nice pocket pass. Wrapped it around his defender to Rink Mast. A beautiful assist that time for Bryce Williams, the Charlotte transfer. 61-50 Cornhuskers. Here's Namari Burnett off a Terrace Reed Jr. screen. Namari driving right past Juwan Gary. Goes up strong. Gary pins it off against the glass. The junkyard dog, Juwan Gary, with the block. Tominaga in transition. Pulls up from the wing. Got it. Keisei Tominaga. Continuing to light it up from distance. 14-point game now, 64-50. Michigan has to find a way to get stops on the defensive side. Terrence Williams, handoff to Namari Burnett. Lost it for a second. Namari tracks it down, working on Josiah Alec on the right wing. Couple dribble moves, now swings at Terrence Williams. Open three in the corner. Can't connect. Terrace Reed Jr. tried to tip it away from Rick Mast, but Keisei Tominaga comes out with it. Tominaga in a hurry. Thought about pulling up, hesitates. Now leaves it for Gary in the corner, up top to Rink Mast. Nice entry pass to Josiah Alec. Had the mismatch with Namari Burnett. And Alec draws a foul. 64-50 with 14:40 left here to play. We head to a media timeout. But the Cornhuskers continue to find ways to score. Keisei Tominaga is streaky as anyone in the country. Tominaga this season has 10 games where he's scored under 10 points. He's got 11 games over 17. He's had games where he scored 2. He's had games where he scored 31. He's got 28 on 11 for 15 shooting today in this one.
Yeah, and five threes of those 11 for 15, 5 for 8 from 3. And that has been a big killer for this Michigan defense. They've had some good defensive possessions, and they get a stop, but then Nebraska will get the offensive rebound and swing it out to Tominaga for a wide open three.
So a 14-point ball game. Nebraska in the lead. And the Wolverines continue to search for answers. And the real shame for Michigan is your offense hasn't exactly struggled. You're at 48% from the field, 45%, 9 for 20 from three-point range, and you trail by 14.
Yeah.
And that should tell you all it needs to about the Michigan defense in this one.
Offensive woes to kind of start this second half. They have not scored at the same rate, and when your defense is lacking as much as it has been, you need that offense to stick where it was at.
I think that's really been a big story for this Michigan team all year, is they've struggled to get stops, and it's a lot to ask your offense to keep up with a Nebraska team that's at nearly 70% of the field. That's an impossible ask, and Michigan has just been one of the worst defensive teams in the Big Ten throughout this season. The 64-50 Cornhuskers leading it. They've come to Ann Arbor and lead by 14 with 14:40 to play in the final game of the regular season for the Michigan Wolverines. CJ Wilcher checks in for Rink Mast for the Cornhuskers. Michigan will trot their starters right back out. Alec will shoot a pair. Josiah Alec played three seasons at the University of Missouri, Kansas City. Last year was at New Mexico. And now has come home, the Lincoln, Nebraska native, wearing the Cornhusker red, makes his first free throw. 65-50 Cornhuskers. Alec's second free throw is up and good as well. 66-50 Nebraska. Doug McDaniel will bring it up for Michigan. He'll be met by Bryce Williams. The 6'7 Williams will match up with Doug McDaniel. McDaniel gets a screen from Cheddar, keeps it, has the switch with CJ Wilcher on him. Now up top to Cheddar. Cheddar handoff to Terrence Williams the second. Williams swings it back over to Doug McDaniel, right wing. Now Burnett replaces him in the right wing. Into the post to Terrace Reed. He's doubled by Gary and Alec. Puts it on the floor. Up top to Doug McDaniel. Wilcher jumps the pass. He's in a hurry in transition. CJ Wilcher lays it up and in. Nice defensive play. Makes his job easy on the offensive end. 68-50 Cornhuskers. 18-point game. McDaniel uses a Terrace Reed Jr. screen. Now skip pass to Terrence Williams the second. Working on Jawan Gary. Outside, Cheddar open three. Puts it up from the wing. That one's off the mark. Alec with the rebound. 68-50 Cornhuskers. Bryce Williams to Alec. Now Keisei Tominaga gets a handoff from Alec. Nice pass inside to Alec and the finish.
That one there for Nebraska puts them on an 11-0 run in the last 2 minutes. Michigan offense just completely gone cold.
And it's a 20-point game. Terrence Williams pump fakes a three, drives inside, gets it up and in, and the foul. Terrence Williams will have a chance to get three the old-fashioned way. Michigan desperately needed a bucket. But boy, oh boy, Michigan cannot get a stop right now. You said it, Gavin, an 11-0 run until that point. Nebraska still five for the last five. Jalen Llewellyn and Trey Jackson will come in for Doug McDaniel and Will Cheddar. Terrence Williams the second will shoot a pair. It'll be T. Will Llewellyn, Trey Jackson, Damari Burnett, and Terrace Reed Jr. Llewellyn boxing out of the free throw as Terrace Reed Jr. awaits at half court to play some defense. Free throw is up and pure for Terrence Williams. 70-53. 2-2-1 press comes from Michigan. Tominaga back to Jamarcus Lawrence, who's checked in, gets it across the timeline to Jawan Gary, leaves it for Lawrence. The sophomore Jamarcus Lawrence, handoff to Jawan Gary. Michigan in a 2-3 zone. Lawrence up top, now back up top to Wilcher. Wilcher fires a deep three with a hand in his face, couldn't get it in. Terrace Reed on the rebound. Llewellyn the other way, 70-53 Cornhuskers, 13 to play here in the second half. Llewellyn picks up his dribble, leaves it for Damari Burnett. Swings it over to Terrence Williams the second, working on Jamarcus Lawrence on the right side. Skip passes, tip. Jawan Gary comes up with it. 3-on-2 the other way. Gary lost it as he tried a Euro step. It's up in the air, bouncing around. Terrence Williams comes out with it for Michigan. Leaves it for Reed Jr. over to Damari Burnett. Open on the pump fake from three in the corner. Can't knock it down. Terrence Williams elevates over Jamarcus Lawrence for the rebound. Misses off the side of the backboard, and Jawan Gary comes up with it. Damari Burnett had as good of a look from three as he'll get all day and couldn't knock it down. Jawan Gary for three the other way. That one's off the mark as well. CJ Wilcher couldn't track it down, so it's 70-53 Cornhuskers with 12:18 left to play in the second half.
Back-to-back stops for Michigan on the defensive end. The press into the 2-3 zone looked good on that first possession, but no offense coming off of it.
Sam Hoiberg in there for Nebraska. He's guarding Jalen Llewellyn. Llewellyn leaves it for Terrace Reed Jr. Working high post, step through, he walked. No, they call a foul. I believe Josiah Alec. His first personal foul, team second. So still 70-53, 20 on the shot clock. Jalen Llewellyn will inbound it to Terrace Reed Jr. High post to Terrence Williams, working on Bryce Williams. Couldn't get it to go, gets his own rebound. And a push called on Terrence Williams as he went and chased down his own rebound. And the Boo Birds ring down here in Crisler. Showed a replay, not a ton there. Josiah Alex skipped to Bryce Williams in the corner. Williams working on Trey Jackson. Into the post to Alec. Nomari Burnett fronting him. C.J. Wilk to Sam Hoiberg. Now Bryce Williams. Burnett still working on Alec in the post. Sam Hoiberg drives. High post. Jamarcus Lawrence open at the elbow. Back iron. Nomari Burnett goes up strong for the rebound. Lawrence fouled him. So it's stop and start here. As we reach the under 12 media timeout, 70 Cornhuskers, 53 Wolverines. And time ticking off the clock, Michigan has to cut into the 17-point lead.
Yeah, finally getting a couple stops here. Nebraska hasn't scored for the last 2 minutes, but Michigan is just 1-for-7 on their last seven shots. And you can get as many stops as you want, but you have to capitalize and get some points off of them as well.
Absolutely, and that's the struggle for this Michigan team. To put it bluntly, there's a lot of reasons this team is sitting at 8-22 and 3-16 in the Big Ten. I mean, Michigan, 3-16, Rutgers in 13th has four more wins in conference at 7-12.
Even in that matchup against Rutgers, even in the last week or so, Michigan, bad loss at Rutgers.
These last two games have not been kind for Michigan. Traveled to Piscataway and to Columbus, Ohio, and got hammered in both of them by over 20. And now at home, they trail by 17 to a Nebraska team. Perhaps it's teams in the red uniforms. They can't find anything against the red. Scarlet Knights, Buckeyes, and now Cornhuskers seem to have the Wolverines' number. 11:38:33 left here in the second half. Thanks for joining us on WCBN Sports. I'm Alex Miller, alongside me, Gavin Briggs. Excited to be here for this final game for Michigan. This will be the final game WCBN covers the Michigan men's team this season, as we'll be unable to make the trip to Minnesota for the Big Ten tournament next week. And barring a miracle, that is where this team's season will come to an end.
Josiah Alec for the Cornhuskers, 15 points now after a great start of the second half. 6-for-6, has done a great job working in the post. Michigan switching a lot on their defense, and he's done a great job of getting open, and Nebraska's done a great job of finding him down there in the post.
Alec in his fifth year, mentioned it earlier, 3 seasons at University of Missouri, Kansas City, last year at New Mexico, and now has made his way home to Lincoln, Nebraska, and he's got a headband and quite a head of hair behind it. And that hair has followed him to the 6-of-6 from the field today. We'll get back underway here. Jalen Llewellyn will walk it up. He's joined by Yo-Yo Kayot, Trey Jackson, Nomari Burnett, and Terrace Reed Jr. Working on Sam Hoiberg, Llewellyn top of the key. Yo-Yo Kayot gets it on the right wing. Over to Nomari Burnett up top. Thought about a three, now goes to the post. Terrace Reed Jr. working on Alec. Pump fakes and then goes up strong and gets a deuce. 70-55, Michigan. Bryce Williams, handoff to Jamarcus Lawrence. Now gets a screen from C.J. Wilcher. Back to Wilcher, left wing. Now Bryce Williams over to Sam Hoiberg, right wing. Jamarcus Lawrence gets a dribble handoff coming up from the corner, puts up a three. It's short. Terrace Reed Jr. on the rebound, and Josiah Alec commits a foul on it. As soon as he did, Rink Mast popped up from the bench. And whoa, in a shoving match here, C.J. Wilcher knocked Yo-Yo Kai out to the ground and then got tied up with Namari Burnett. Some scenes here. Fred Hoiberg calming down an irate C.J. Wilcher. And I've watched nearly every game this Cornhusker team has played this season, just really enjoy their style. And C.J. Wilcher is not normally a guy to bring that kind of attitude, and now the play is under review. Well, not what I was expecting here in the Crisler Center. 10:53 left here in the second half, and they'll go to the boards to check on perhaps a flagrant or a tech here on C.J. Wilcher or Yo-Yo Kayot. Not sure. I'd imagine if something gets called, it has to go on Wilcher. C.J. Wilcher listed as a junior. He had a year at Xavier and then last two at Nebraska. He graduated in 3 years, but he still has another year of eligibility after this one. He was honored at Nebraska's senior day. Oh, here's the replay finally. Bryce Williams took a bump from Yo-Yo Kayot, shoved him back. Oh, so it was Williams who shoved Kayot. Not to exaggerate, but a little bit of a flop there from Yo-Yo, but there was an extension of the arm. Bryce Williams was the actor, though, not Wilcher. It was Wilcher, though, who did get head-to-head with Namari Burnett afterward, and the refs will look to sort this one out, but perhaps this could be a momentum swing for the Wolverines, down 15, and if Bryce Williams or Wilcher's status, I guess it'd have to be Bryce Williams after seeing that replay, if anything changes. That'd be a leader of this Nebraska team off the floor for Michigan in their comeback attempts.
Interested to see what the refs come up with here. Watching that replay, it's kind of hard to tell. I mean, there was definitely a shove from Nebraska, so you would think if anything gets called, it will at least go Nebraska's way, if not maybe an additional call for Michigan.
So we wait and see. Cornhuskers still lead it by 15. They've come into Ann Arbor and shot the lights out. Cooled off a little bit from three. They're still just under 40%, but still over 60% from the field. Referees are still taking a look at the scorer's table, and amusingly, Fred Hoiberg and company are still in the huddle talking things over. The Michigan five on the floor are already back on the court awaiting this call. Now Juwan Howard and Phil Martelli approach, but one ref has stepped away. Now all three refs step away from the table. They'll convene and we'll see what the call is. Still deliberating, seemingly. A point at the scorer's table toward the Nebraska huddle. Not sure what any of this means. Phil Martelli and Juwan Howard standing on the court chatting with Yo-Yo Kai, Namari Burnett, Trey Jackson, Terrace Reed Jr., and Jalen Llewellyn. Long stoppage here. All three refs still together, about five strides away from the scorer's table. Yo-Yo Kayat doing some running in place to still stay loose. One ref will go talk to Juwan Howard. One will talk to Fred Hoiberg. The other will head toward the TV announcer's table, and we'll see what call comes. All three of these chats taking a little while. The only chat still going on is the one with Fred Hoiberg. and hopefully we should get an announcement. Bryce Williams and CJ Wilcher are walking back on the floor, so perhaps there is no ejection.
Interested to see how this will affect the rest of the game. Looks like Michigan will take a technical free throw.
So Kyatt will shoot a free throw. Nobody near him. Everyone else at the half-court line. Yusuf Kyatt, 7 for 9 from the stripe coming into this one. Free throw is off the mark. Oh, so a tech goes on Williams, presumably from the shove, and then a tech also on C.J. Wilcher and Namari Burnett for their moment of jawing with each other. Kyatt goes 1 for 2 on his technical free throws. The other two will cancel out. That'll do it from the stripe. And now Michigan will have possession. So a 14-point game. They get a free point out of it. 70-56. So Jalen Llewellyn will bring it up. Long stoppage, but we're back. 10:50 to go here in the second half. Llewellyn picks up his dribble over to Namari Burnett, left wing. Up top, Trey Jackson. The southpaw swings it over to Yusuf Kyatt on the right wing, looking for Terrace Reed in the post. Double comes Hoiberg on the help. Michigan swings it over to Namari Burnett, left wing. 10 on the shot clock. Goes between the legs about 4 times. Now hesitates, drives to his left, loses his dribble to the corner. Llewellyn, Hoiberg on him, 4 seconds to go. Inside of Trey Jackson, puts it up and is fouled. So Trey Jackson will shoot a pair.
Slow offense from Michigan here.
Yeah.
I mean, not including that little break there, Michigan is now on a 6-0 run over the last 3 minutes. I mean, 6 points in 3 minutes isn't great, but getting a couple stops there has been huge.
Trey Jackson, first free throw is good. He's at around 70% from the stripe this season. Here's the second free throw. That one is good as well. So this game is back down to a 12-point deficit. 70-58. Keisei Tominaga heads to the scorer's table. Rink Mast over to Bryce Williams. Jamarcus Lawrence comes and gets it. Now dribble handoff to Wilcher. Up top to Rink Mast. Mast over to Bryce Williams, left wing. Yusuf Kyatt working hard on him. Now he gets a screen from Mast. Kyatt fights through and fouls Williams as he went up around the rim. So Bryce Williams, who's one of the best free throw shooters on the conference, in the conference, best on this Cornhusker team, 84%, will shoot a pair for Nebraska. Williams takes 3 dribbles, spins the ball in his hands. First free throw is up, nothing but the net. And Tominaga checks in for C.J. Wilcher. Michigan has Llewellyn, Kyatt, Burnett, Trey Jackson, and Terrace Reed Jr. Williams puts up his second free throw. That one is good as well. 72-58 Cornhuskers. Llewellyn will walk it up. Sam Hoiberg, a pit bull at the top of this Cornhusker defense, will guard him. Llewellyn uses a screen from Terrace Reed Jr. to his right. Now crosses over. High off the glass. Banks it in. A pretty move. Jalen Llewellyn cuts it back to 12. Rink Mass, the big man, brings it up, pulls up for a 3. It's off the iron. Sam Hoiberg came flying in. Terrace Reed Jr. puts it above his head. Hoiberg can't get up that high. Jalen Llewellyn uses a screen from Reed Jr. over to Kyatt. One more to Trey Jackson. Corner gun. Off the iron. 72-60, under 10 to play here. Bryce Williams in a hurry, crosses over and draws a foul from Trey Jackson. Williams really good at drawing the contact, sort of leaned in on the first step and drew the contact and gets to go back to the stripe to shoot a pair where he's at around 85%.
Nebraska getting a little bit of offense coming in. They're not, still have not made a field goal in 4 minutes, but have definitely started to attack the cup and give themselves some free throws. I bet they're probably looking to get the ball back in Keisei Tominaga's hands, get themselves some more shooting. And he's been really good at creating layups and threes all the same today.
Williams knocks down them both, 74-69. 16 and ticking left here. Jalen Llewellyn uses a screen from Terrace Reed Jr. moving right. Now behind his back on Sam Hoiberg. And Hoiberg called on a reach there. And Michigan enters the bonus with 9:10 left here in the second half. So Jalen Llewellyn will shoot a pair, and that's a big-time boon to this Wolverine comeback effort. As you'll keep getting chances, one and one this time, Llewellyn knocks the front one down. 74-61, Nebraska. Llewellyn's second free throw is good. And it goes back to 12. 74 Cornhuskers, 62 Wolverines. 2-2-1 press. Tominaga across the timeline up to Bryce Williams. Tominaga has Yusuf Kayat on him. Now swings it over to Jamarcus Lawrence up top to Rink Mast with Terrace Reed Jr. Mast looking for a cut. Bryce Williams on the back cut. Pretty cut. Pretty pass. Nice assist from Rink Mast. 76-62. Mast saw over the top of the defense and dropped it in. Llewellyn picks up his dribble. Kayat in the corner. Hesitates. Now puts up a three back iron. Rebound tipped out by Terrace Reed Jr. Llewellyn has it. Extra possession coming for Michigan. Llewellyn skip pass to Burnett. And he stepped on the sideline as he started to drive downhill.
Mass today for Nebraska, playing a lot near the top of the key, feeding into the post, feeding the other guards on the court. But, he's had a great day, just been very versatile for them.
76-62 Cornhuskers, 8:20 now and ticking left here in the second half. Sam Hoiberg right wing up top, Jamarcus Lawrence uses a Bryce Williams screen into Williams high post, working on Terrence Williams the second. Rink Mast gets it in the post, elevates over Terrace Reed, can't have it. Sam Hoiberg almost had the rebound, came from behind. Terrace Reed didn't see him, but Terrace ends up with it. Doug McDaniel splits a pick and roll up and under. Whoa, that would have been something special, but McDaniel couldn't get it over the rim. Mass now at top of the key. Off ball action. Now Tominaga comes through, and Mast is fouled by Terrence Williams the second as he tried to chase Tominaga. Under 8 media timeout. Cornhuskers by 14, 76-62. This lead has been pretty consistent for Nebraska since they took it. Michigan has not been able to cut it to less than 12.
Recently, this game has been a lot slower than it was in that first half. First half, lots of scoring. Both teams lighting it up, but it's been a lot slower, a lot more missed shots, even turnovers, and a lot more fouls called in the second half as well.
It's been a bit more stop and start. The pace was so rapid in the first half. It's 76-62. If Michigan wants to make this one interesting, they've got to start cutting into this lead sooner rather than later.
Tominaga, 28 today, but he only has 5 in the second half. I 2 for 3 in the second half, but definitely has not been nearly as aggressive. Hasn't been on the court as much, but definitely has not been taking nearly as many shots as he was in the first half. And I wonder if maybe that's linked to the defense of Yo-Yo Kayat, putting him on Tominaga recently. Maybe the bigger defender has been the move for Michigan.
Kayat's done a really good job moving his feet, staying in front on defense. He's really brought some energy to Michigan's defensive squad. And Michigan needing some energy on defense right now as they look to find a way to chop this Nebraska lead back down. ...76-63 76-62. Thanks for tuning in to WCBN Sports. Student radio coverage of Michigan athletics. It's been a pleasure to cover Michigan basketball this season, and we'll be back next year, of course. And as Michigan looks to improve next year, nowhere to go but up. They're going to finish this year in the cellar of the Big Ten, and
would love next year to be a little more competitive in these Big Ten games.
Absolutely. So Rink Mast will shoot a pair. Rink Mast, 4 years at Bradley, previous to Nebraska. One of those years was a redshirt year. He's a junior eligibility-wise with COVID year. First free throw is good. And Mast at Bradley led them in scoring and rebounds, 13.8, 8.0. And the fact that those numbers are pretty similar to what he's brought to Nebraska, his transition to Big Ten basketball has been huge for this team's success. Second free throw, toilet bowl is out. 15-point game, 77-62. Under 8 to play. Doug McDaniel left wing up top. Trey Jackson now hands it back off to McDaniel. Use a Terrace Reed screen to Terrence Williams, the second right wing. Enters the post to Terrace Reed. Double comes from Tominaga. Reed dribbles it. Terrence Williams left wing now to Namari Burnett. Burnett drives. Help comes from Rink Mast. And it came off, I believe, of the knee of Rink Mast. So it'll stay with Michigan. 9 on the shot clock. 7:25 left here in the second half. Trey Jackson moving. Now Terrace Reed Jr. sets a screen for McDaniel. He can't get screen. Burnett looking for something. Terrace Reed Jr. goes out to the logo to catch it. McDaniel driving left floater. That one's off the glass. McDaniel got his own board sometime. That one, somehow, excuse me, and he missed that one as well. Two tough looks for McDaniel. Demarcus Lawrence now up top to Rink Mast. Back to Lawrence on the right wing as Terrace Reed Jr. on him. Lawrence attacks, goes downhill, kick to the corner. Namari Burnett got a hand on it. Here goes Michigan in transition. Burnett leaps for McDaniel. And now Doug slows it down. Terrence Williams, short corner on the right side. Now Namari Burnett, left wing, back up top to T-Will. Now left wing, they forgot about Burnett. Open three from the wing. Can't rattle it home. Michigan has struggled to knock down threes in this second half. 77-62, still Cornhuskers. Namari Burnett called for a foul as he impeded the way of Rink Mast trying to get to the post, and Nebraska in the bonus, so Mast will shoot a pair. Juwan Gary returns for Jamarcus Lawrence for the Cornhuskers. Will Cheddar in for Michigan alongside Namari Burnett, Terrace Reed Jr., Terrence Williams the second, and Doug McDaniel. Mast knocks down the first free throw. 78-62 Cornhuskers.
Both teams ice cold from the floor. Nebraska 1-for-7 on their last field goals, and Michigan 2-for-their-last-11. So both teams really struggling to score when it's not from the free throw line.
Mast knocked down the second free throw, 79-62. 17-point game, 6:30 to play here. Will Cheddar gets a screen from Doug McDaniel, moving to his right. McDaniel skip pass to Terrence Williams on the left side. Post to Cheddar. Now back up top to the left wing to Williams. Posting up, Sam Hoiberg drives in, left hand. It's off the mark. Whistle blows. That's Sam Hoiberg's third. And Terrence Williams will head to the stripe. 17-point game, 6:16 left here in the second half.
Both teams in the bonus, so probably going to have a lot more free throws in this second half, slowing it down like we've talked about. A much slower pace in the first half, and it'll look to stay that way.
They ruled it a foul on the floor, so Terrence Williams misses the front end, and that's all he gets at the stripe. So 79-62, an empty possession effectively for Michigan. Bryce Williams, left wing, gets a screen from Tominaga. Sam Hoiberg, right wing, open three off the iron, and that one will bounce over to the Nebraska bench out of bounds. Sam Hoiberg, quiet in the box score, but he's made some effective plays, as he does for Nebraska with his hustle and defense. Under six to play. Burnett, right wing to Terrace Reed Jr.
Dribble handoff to Terrence Williams. Now McDaniel coming the other way. Pocket pass to Reed. Floater. And Terrence Reed Jr. gets it to go. Michigan was 0 for their last six. Finally gets a field goal. Mass to a cutting Gary under the basket. Gary finishes. Too easy for the Cornhuskers.
Both teams breaking streaks of not being able to score. Just like you just said, Michigan was 0 for their last six before, and Nebraska hadn't made a field goal for the last 3 minutes before that one.
81-64. Mass jumps a pass for Terrence Reed Jr. Burnett runs it down. Up to Doug McDaniel, left wing. Working on Juwan Gary in the corner. Up to Will Cheddar on the left wing. Now Burnett over to Terrence Williams. He drives right side. Euro steps around Mast. Tried to pass it, and Keisei Tominaga gets in the passing lane on a pass that didn't have enough velocity on it. 81-64. Tominaga on a cut. This time McDaniel jumps the passing lane. Here comes Namari Burnett right wing. Burnett working inside. Tried to get it in to Terrence Reed Jr. And the pass hit the knee of Rink Mast. It'll stay with Michigan out of bounds. 81-64, 4-4-4 left here to play in the second half. McDaniel the inbounder on the baseline. Terrence Williams gets it short corner. Burnett comes off a screen, gets it at the elbow. Over to Doug McDaniel on the right wing. Doug jabs right, goes left, driving past Hoiberg, flips it up with the right hand. It rattles just off. Alec with the rebound for Nebraska. Here's Tominaga. He's had a quiet second half. No one stops the ball. Terrence Reed Jr. just watched Tominaga walk on by to the cup. And Casey gets his easiest bucket of the afternoon. 83-64, the lead up to 19. Juwan Howard, timeout.
Tominaga now to 30 points, crossing the threshold. Michigan, no defense on that last play. Just letting him walk to the basket. Going to need a lot more effort than that if they're going to come back from a 19-point deficit.
83-64.
Tominaga leads all players in scoring with 30 today. Doug leads Michigan with 17. Nebraska still shooting above 60% on the day. Michigan at a 43% clip. Both teams have definitely cooled off from the first half, but Nebraska still keeping their foot on the pedal. I mean, 80 points through three quarters of the second half, that's a good number to be at, and
yeah,
you're going to win a lot of games there.
Absolutely. And Michigan has continued to struggle to get stops. It's been a little bit more stop and start with both teams in the bonus and a lot of trips to the free throw line, but Nebraska is still over 60% from the field with 4:30 to go in this one. I mean, that's for Michigan, you can't win games if your opponent is shooting 62% from the field. And for the Cornhuskers, you've got to feel pretty good about how your offense has operated at this one.
Definitely. And Michigan, like in the Michigan State game, that they played really well for 75%, 80% of that game. And that last 5-10 minutes or so of the second half, Michigan State kind of took it away because Michigan's defense slowed down. Both teams were really struggling from the field. Michigan State didn't hit a three for most of the game. It's really keeping up that effort on defense, staying in front of the opposition, and that's going to win you games. But days like today, you're not going to be as close.
Alex Miller, Gavin Briggs, as we wrap up the broadcast, Cam, thanks for sticking with us in this one. Cornhuskers by 19, 83-64. 4:26 to go here. Namari Burnett to inbound with Doug McDaniel, Will Cheddar, Terrence Reed Jr., Terrence Williams the second. Starters for Michigan: Sam Hoiberg, Keisei Tominaga, Josiah Alec, Juwan Gary, and Bryce Williams for Nebraska. Doug on the right wing with Hoiberg on him. Up top to Terrence Williams the second. Pump fakes, drives past Gary. Pass is trying to get it to Will Cheddar, But Williams was fouled trying to fire that pass. It'll go on Bryce Williams, and with both teams in the bonus, Michigan actually enters the double bonus there on the 10th foul. So Terrence Williams will shoot two.
The play of Sam Hoiberg has been really key in the second half. He's done a great job matching up on Doug McDaniel, been a great matchup for him for Nebraska, and McDaniel has struggled a lot more in the second half.
First free throw is good for Terrence Williams, and Sam Hoiberg, the, of course, son of head coach Fred Hoiberg for Nebraska. I think there's an argument Sam Hoiberg is the most valuable walk-on in the country after he's carved out a role in this Nebraska rotation. Second free throw good as well for Terrence Williams. 66-83. Michigan goes press. Cornhuskers beat it with ease. Sam Hoiberg right wing. Over to Keisei Tominaga. Jabs. Burnett slips. Tominaga up and under. Nice help defense there from Michigan. Loose ball. McDaniel lets it go out of bounds off of Sam Hoiberg. So with 3:57 left here, Michigan down 83-66. McDaniel will walk it up for Michigan. Will Cheddar and Terrace Reed will each offer a screen. He'll use Reed's to his left now, to his right, up now to the left side, Will Cheddar. Terrence Williams, short corner double comes from Alec and Bryce Williams. Left wing to Cheddar, skip pass to Burnett, almost jumped by Tominaga. Burnett's three is short. Michigan cannot buy a three-pointer. 83-66, under 3:30 to play here. Alec, top of the key. Now Jawan Gary left wing. Bryce Williams comes and gets it from him. Williams has Terrace Reed Jr., likes the matchup, drives right. Scoop shot is short. Will Cheddar working on Alec. And the whistle will go, I believe, on Will Cheddar.
Michigan finalist number 42, Will Cheddar. That'll be his fourth personal foul. Team's nine. Previous play is under further review.
So they'll review this one, and 83-66, 3:10. Michigan's hopes of winning this game all but extinguished. Not enough time left in what has been a lackluster second half for Michigan.
Going back to Sam Hoiberg, made a couple tip plays in the backcourt against Doug McDaniel, just getting the ball tipped away and having to go run back after it. Just like small, big plays for Nebraska. I mean, he's only taken one shot today. He missed a three-pointer in the middle of the second half, but Sam Hoiberg has done a great job of just keeping consistent and making the other team's players' lives a lot harder today.
So after the review, still a common foul on Cheddar. And Nebraska has a couple of guys who just can be difference makers on defense. Sam Hoiberg, one of them. Jawan Gary, certainly one of them. The man at the free throw line, Josiah Alec, one of them. Alec will shoot a pair. Or excuse me, he'll shoot one and one. First one's off back iron. Terrence Williams with the rebound. Namari Burnett will bring it up right wing. Left handoff to Doug McDaniel. Uses a screen from Terrace Reed Jr. Doug has Bryce Williams on him on the right wing. Now Will Cheddar right wing. Cheddar picks up his dribble, looking left side to Terrence Williams. One more to Burnett in the corner. Namari drives and draws a foul. Josiah Alec, who committed the foul, went to go help him up and then slipped himself. And the mop will come out. And Namari Burnett will shoot a pair for Michigan.
Couple players in foul trouble for both sides now. Cheddar has four after that foul on the other side. Terrence Williams second with three. And then Nebraska has Bryce Williams, Sam Hoiberg, and Josiah Alec all with three.
Amari Burnett first free throw rattles it in off the front rim. He took one of the longest dips down, bent the knees, and was down there for a good 3 or 4 seconds before elevating for the free throw. Amari takes a wide base at the free throw line. Here's the low stance. Solid 5 seconds, now elevates and shoots that one good as well. Whatever works, Amari Burnett knocks down both free throws, 83-68, 2:47 and ticking left here in this ball game. Bryce Williams by the logo on the left side, just taking the time off the clock, 15 on the shot clock. Everyone waiting for something to happen. Tomi Naga set up to screen for Williams and does. Now right wing Hoiberg into the corner, Juwan Gary. Gary drives baseline, gets to the cup and finishes with the left hand. Cornhuskers did exactly what they wanted, took the whole shot clock and got an easy bucket at the basket. 85-68. Doug McDaniel up top, gets a screen from Will Cheddar to his right. Into the corner to Amari Burnett. Burnett fires from the corner after a pump fake. That one is off the mark. Michigan cannot get a three-pointer to go in the second half. 85-68, Cornhuskers under two to play here. Jackson Salvala headed to the scorer's table. His senior, he was honored at senior night. Former team manager George Washington there as well as some bench players for the Cornhuskers. Keisei Tominaga was waiting the clock to go, and then Fred Hoiberg takes a timeout for substitutions. It's the walk-on Jeffrey Grace Jr., the freshman Matar Diop, and another walk-on Cale Jacobson. And the crowd applauds as Jackson Salvala, the senior, former team manager, I like to say he's a very nicely mustachioed man. He has been for most of this season. As he plays his final minutes for the Maize and Blue. George Washington III also enters. Under a minute 42 to play. Cale Jacobson will inbound, gets it into Hoiberg. Washington III got a hand on it. Hoiberg drives downhill, gets to the cup, misses the bunny, and stepped out of bounds trying to get it. Henry Burt also in there, another walk-on for Nebraska. And now Michigan will send Ian Burns for Doug McDaniel as they slowly transition the starters out. And as Doug McDaniel exits, I mean, this was a very interesting season for Doug. In a way, he was this whole team at times, and a lot was put on his plate as a sophomore, and hope he'll be back in the Maize and Blue next year. Ian Burns, top of the key, over to Llewellyn, left wing. Llewellyn crosses over. Jumper fired by Salvala, and he's fouled on the shot. So Jackson Salvala, who on the season is 0 for 3 from the field, 2 for 2 from the stripe, will get a chance to add to his career point total at the stripe. Yeah, so Vala looks like shaved the mustache he'd had all year. Got a haircut as well for senior day. Knocks down his first free throw. Puts himself in the box score on senior day. Takes one dribble, second free throw is good as well. So Jackson Salvala will leave his Michigan career 4 for 4 at the charity stripe. 15-point game, 85-70, a minute and 10 ticking, 70 seconds. Sam Hoiberg will walk it up. Hoiberg just dribbling it out at the logo. George Washington III up on him. Over to Burt, back to Hoiberg. Now going to get a screen from Matar Diop. Doesn't use it. Kicks it to Burt. The walk-on fires his three. It's a knuckleball. Comes up short. Salvala tracks down the rebound. Here comes Llewellyn the other way. To Trey Jackson. He'll fire a triple. That one is off. Michigan still can't buy a three. And Jeffrey Grace, the third, got the rebound and was fouled. So now a Nebraska walk-on will get a chance to get some points.
Michigan has not made a shot in the last 5 minutes of this game, and one for their last 11 attempts. Definitely not the end to the season that you would have wanted to have. Definitely not the end of the second half after a great first half, but great fight in the first half, and it was a competitive one for there.
Grace the third misses both free throws. Some hands on heads in the Nebraska bench. They wanted the walk on to get some points. Llewellyn uses a screen from Sovala. Ian Burns fires a catch and shoot triple. He can't buy it. Matar Diop the rebound and under 30 to play. That'll do it. 20 seconds left. It's all a formality. Nebraska will dribble this one out and win it. 85 to 70. And Michigan will finish the 2023-2024 season with under 10 wins. They finished 8-22. Hard to put it any nicer, but an abysmal Big Ten season at 3-17. Nebraska, on the other hand, moved to 22-9. They pick up a road win to go 12-8 in conference as they finish up what should be an NCAA tournament-bound resume. So, Gavin, any final thoughts on this game, this season at large for the Michigan Wolverines?
Definitely a struggle of a season, but they're going to go into the Big Ten tournament. Hope to maybe make some noise, have a big upset in the first round or so, but that's probably where their season will end, and Nebraska will look to do what they can in the Big Ten tournament and have as much of a run as they can in the NCAA tournament.
And Nebraska has locked up a double bye with this win, 12-8. Wisconsin was also 11-8 as of today, but Nebraska beat them head-to-head. I believe they hold the tiebreak. I don't know who's clear from this broadcast, and I mentioned it once. I've watched this Nebraska team nearly all of their games this season. I really fell in love with their team last year with the play of Derek Walker over his Nebraska career and what Keisei Tominaga brings, his energy on a basketball court, and I'll be rooting for the Cornhuskers down the road. But looking for Michigan, it was a up-and-down season with a lot more downs than there were ups, and Juwan Howard, if he's back, has a lot of questions to find answers to this offseason. You lose Trey Jackson, you lose Jalen Llewellyn, you lose Namari Burnett, you lose Terrence Williams II, you lose Olivier Kamwa, Jackson Sovala as well, and a lot of talent to replace, and the Maize and Blue have a big upward climb if they want to return to their longtime spot in the upper echelon of the Big Ten.
Definitely would like to get back to even just 3, 4, 5 years ago. Great teams in the NCAA tournament, great teams in Big Ten play. And they definitely want to get back to that Final Four like they did in 2018.
So that'll do it for us. Just want to give one shout out to Owen Klein on the first half, his final Michigan basketball game for a guy who spent a lot of time on the mic here in Crisler Center. So thanks to Owen for his contributions to WCBN over his time here at Michigan, and to the rest of our seniors whose career at Crisler is over. And that'll about do it for our broadcast, as Owen Klein leaves with a heart to all you faithful listeners. And thank you to everyone who's tuned into our coverage this season. It's been a pleasure to cover this men's basketball team this year. We'll look for more and better coming next year. So for Owen Klein, Shai Dweck, and Gavin Briggs, my partner for the second half, I'm Alex Miller, and we'll leave you as we always do with a good afternoon and a go blue. Take care, folks.